गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 12 रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शंस एक्सरसाइज 12.1। इन दिस एक्सरसाइज वी ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 to 7। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। व्हाट हैव बीन क्वेश्चन नंबर 8? क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 हैव इन अ ईयर सीमा अर्न 1,50,000 रुपीज and saves 50,000 rupees. Find the ratio, part A of this question, money that Seema earns to the money she saves. And second part of this question is B part, is that money that she saves to money she spends. Okay, so first we write here what money Seema earns, okay, in a year. So Seema earns, and Seema earn, how many Seema earns in a year? This earns 1,50,000. Okay, this is clear. This money earned by Seema, 1,50,000, we can write here. Now, so how many money she saved? So money saved by Seema, yes, Seema saved money. You can write here direct, saved money. This is equal to nothing but 50,000. Okay, this is clear. Now, what money is spent by Seema in every year? I mean, in each year. So you can find it. Money spent by Seema, this is equal to money earned minus money saves. Okay. So how can you find money spent by Seema? So we subtract saved money from the earned money. Okay. So you can write here money spends this is equal to money earned minus money saved. Okay, so this is equal to you can write here money earned by Seema, this is equal to 1,50,000, clear, minus money saved by Seema, this is equal to 50,000. Okay, so in this way we find the money spent by Seema in each year is how many lakh? 1,00,000. Clear? So every year Seema spend 1,00,000 rupees. So first question arise here, what is a ratio? We need to find the ratio of money that Seema earn to money Seema saves. So we find the ratio of first A part, ratio of money earn to money saved. Okay, so this is equal to money earned, you can write here 1,50,000. This is money earned by Seema and this is a money saved by Seema is 50,000. Okay, here you can see in this question, this is given that money earned by Seema in each year is 1,50,000 and money saved by Seema is 50,000. Okay, so here you need to find the ratio of money that earned to the money she saves. So, okay, so here you can see 1,50,000 is money earned by Seema in each year, and she saved in each year 50,000. So ratio you can write here 150,000 by 50. So you can cancel it. 0000. Then you have here 15 by 5. Clear? So also you know if you divide 15 by 5, then up to no 3. Okay. So also you can simplify it. This is equal to 3 by 1. So ratio of money earned to money saved. Okay. This is equal to 3:1. This is clear? Now in B part. This is B part is given to find the ratio debt money earned to money spent. Sorry, this is given that B part money debt C saves to the money C spent. Okay, so it means that we find the ratio of money saved to money spent. Okay, so what money saved? Money C saved 50,000 rupees and C spent 1,00,000 rupees. Okay, so we can write here, this is B part, ratio of money and money saved to money spent. Okay, so here you can see money saved is 50,000. This is clear. Now money spent is 1,00,000. This is clear. So you can cancel it. 10 10 10 10. Then you have here 5 by 10. 5 by 10. So you also know 5 5 5 5 10. So it's become what? It's become 1 by 2. 5, 1 is 5. 5, 2 is 10. So it becomes 1 by 2. So you can write the ratio of money saved to money spent. This is equal to 1:2. This is clear. So in this question, first this is given and that in a year, Seema earns 1,50,000 rupees and saves 50,000 rupees. Find the ratio money that she saves to the money she earned. Okay, and second part, B part of this question is that money that she saves to the money she spent. So first you find what the spend money. Okay, so for this we subtract save money from earn money. So here earn money is 150,000, save money is 50,000. Then we obtained here 1,00,000. 1,00,000 is the spend money. Now after this we find the ratio. What is first question? First question arises here that what is the ratio of the earn money to save money. So earn money is 1,50,000. Same money is 50,000, so its ratio is 3:1. Okay, and after this second part, this is given, find the ratio of the money saved to money spent. So money saved here 50,000, but money spent here 1,00,000. So in this way, we find the ratio between them 1:2. This 1:2 is the ratio of money saved to money spent, and 3:1 is the ratio of money earned to money saved. So student, I hope all of you understood. Now we are going to discuss next question. Next question is question number 9. So what is question number 9? Let's see. Question number 9 have, there are 102 teachers in a school of 3,300 students. Find the ratio of the numbers of teacher to the number of students. Okay, so this is given that in a school 102 teachers and how many students? 3,300. So we need to find the ratio of the number of teacher to the number of students. Okay, so let's see how to find the ratio of the number of teacher and number of student. And but this is given that number of teacher is 102 and the number of student and number of student is 3300. So let's see. In this question, this is given that number of teacher in a school is equal to 102 and number of students in this school is 3300. So for this, if we divide the 102 by 3300, then you obtain the ratio of teacher to the students. Okay, so first we write here number of teacher. Number of teacher. This is equal to 102. Clear? And number of students in a class, in a school. Number of student. In a school is 3300. This is given that number of teachers and number of students in a school, this is given at 102 and 3300 respectively. Okay, we need to find the ratio of number of teachers to the number of students. Okay, so you find here ratio of number of teacher, number of teachers to the number of students. Students. Okay, so this is given in 102 is teacher and 3300. This is a students. Okay, if you simplify it, then you obtain the number of teachers and number of students. Okay, so first you can divide it by 2 or you can divide it by 3, then you can simplify it. Okay, so if you divide by 3, it will happen here 3 is 9 and 3 4 is 9. Okay, clear? And again, it's divide you by 3, then you open 3 1 jar 3, 3 1 jar 3. Clear? Now, again, if you divide by 2, then you obtain 17. 17 2 jar 34, and here if you divide it by 2, then you obtain 515. 5 2 jar 10, and 5 2 jar 10 and 11. This is equal to. So if you simplify 102 by 3300, then we obtain 17 by 550. So you can write its ratio. This is equal to what? The ratio of teacher and student in school. This is equal to 17 ratio 550. So student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Okay. In this question, this is given in a school 102 teachers and 3300 students. So you need to find the ratio of teacher to the ratio of students. Okay, we need to find the ratio of the number of teachers to the number of students. Okay, so for this, first you divide 102 by 3300, then we simplified it, we obtain 17 by 550. So you can write it in the ratio 17 ratio 550, because if you write it A ratio B, you can write it A by B, or A by B, you can write it A ratio B. Okay, so according to this, we can write 17 by 550. This is equal to 17 ratio 550. Clear? Now, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10 है, इन ए कॉलेज आउट ऑफ 4,320 स्टूडेंट्स 2,300 आर गर्ल्स. फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ नंबर ऑफ गर्ल्स टू द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. बी पार्ट, फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ नंबर ऑफ बॉय टू द नंबर ऑफ गर्ल्स. ओके, एंड सी पार्ट, फाइंड द रेशियो टू द बॉय टू द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, सो लेट्स सी हाउ वी सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, एक्सरसाइज 12.1. ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी रीड इट. इन दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर टोटल स्टूडेंट्स आर गिवन, टोटल स्टूडेंट आप स्कूल गिवन, एंड नंबर ऑफ गर्ल्स इज आल्सो गिवन. सो वी नीड टू फाइंड फर्स्ट नंबर ऑफ बॉय एंड देन वी फाइंड द रेशियो बॉय टू गर्ल्स, गर्ल्स टू द टोटल स्टूडेंट एंड टोटल बॉयज टू द बॉयज द टोटल स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, सो लेट्स सी, फर्स्ट यू राइट हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 10, टोटल स्टूडेंट इन कॉलेज. सो टोटल स्टूडेंट इज गिवन 4,320. ओके, सो राइट हियर टोटल स्टूडेंट, टोटल स्टूडेंट, टोटल स्टूडेंट is to days. This is called what is total student here 4,320. So this is called 4,320. This is a total students. Now and again given number of girls, total number of girls. Total number of girls, this is equal to 2,300. Total girls, total number of girls, this is equal to 2,300. Okay, again, and total number of boys, this is equal to what? How can you find total number of boys if the total student in a college is given 4,320 and the total girls is also given 2,300? So you need to find total number of boys. So for this, if you subtract number of girls to the total number of students in the college, then you obtain total number of boys in the college. Okay, so for this you can write here, and this is equal to 4,320 minus 2,300. Okay, so you can subtract direct, or you can take here column method like this: 4,320 subtracted 2,300. Here so you obtain 0, again here write 2, again here 0. This is 2. Okay. So you can see here we have 2020. Okay, so in this way you find the number of student, total number of student in the college is 2020, total number of girls in college is 2300, and total strength of college, you can say total number of student in college is 4,320. Okay, so first question arises here, and number find the ratio of number of girls to the total number of students. Okay, so first you find ratio. Now this is a part, a ratio of number of girls to, we find the ratio of number of girls to the total number of students, to the total number of students
students. This is equal to total number of girls is here given 2300, and total students are given here 4320. Okay,
so first we simplify. After this you write in the formula ratio. If you cancel this 0 by 0, then we obtain here 230 and divide by 432. Okay, so which number second they cancelled, so you can divide by 2 in each case, means numerator and denominator, numerator and denominator divide by 2, then you obtain here 2 1 2, again 2 1 2, 2 5 10, 2 1 2, 2 1 2, you have 5, so you complete 2 5 10. Now when you divide it, 2 2 4, 2 1 2, and 2 7 ja 2 6 ja 12, 2 1 ja 2, 2 2 ja 4 here, 2 1 ja 2, and it become 12, so 2 6 ja 12, so this you obtain 115 divided by 216. So what is come between them? Anything come? Nothing is come between them. Okay, because this is divisible by 3, but this number is not divisible by 3, because this is divisible by only 5. Okay, because you can see sum of the digit of the number 5 plus 1 plus 1, this is equal to 7, this is not divisible by 3. Okay, so this number will be divisible by 5. Okay, so it, you can already you can see 115 and 216 is a 1. This is a co-prime numbers. Okay, so you can write the ratio of this number is 115 and ratio 216. This is clear. So now the next part, what is the next part of this question? Number of students, find the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls. Okay, so B part of this question, ratio of number of ratio of number of boys to the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls. Number of girls. So number of boys here you find, what is the number of boys? 2020. 2020 is the number of boys. Here you can write 2020 and divide by which numbers you can divide it? Number of girls. Number of girls is 2300 is number of girls. So you can cancel here. 00 cancel, and here you obtain 202 in numerators, and the denominators you obtain 230. Again we divide it by 2, then we obtain here 2 1 2 0 2 1 2. And for this, if you divide it, then we obtain here it's become 2 1 2, and 2 1 2 2 5 2. Okay, so here what is common between them? You can see nothing is common between them, because 101 and 115. So you can write it, the ratio is equal to 101 ratio 115. This is clear. So you can see here, you find the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls. This is equal to 101 ratio 115. Now the third part of this question is that find the ratio of number of boys to the total number of students. Okay, so for this, when we read it here, the ratio, the number of boys to the
total students. This is clear. So this is C part. We find in C part a ratio of number of boys to the total number of students. So write here ratio of number of boys to the total number of students. Okay, so total number of students is given here 4020. How many students here? 4320. 4320 students are given here, and total number of students we find here. Sorry, first you write total number of students. Okay, this is given here 2020, and total number of students in a school, in college is given here 4320. Okay, if you cancel 0 by 0, then you obtain here 222 and 432. Again, you can, if you divide it, then we obtain this is equal to 21201 upon 224 and 260. This is clear now. So you can see here, this is the required ratio is 101:216. 101:216. This is a required ratio. Now, student, I hope all have understood that how to find the ratio of given two numbers. In this question, this is given the number of boys we find. Number of total students is given 4320, and number of girls in college also given 2300. To be find the number of boys, how can you find number of boys? If we subtract the number of girls from the total number of student in the college, then we find the number of boys. So for this, here you can see this 4320 is the total number of students in the college, and 2300, this is a number of girls. So if you subtract them, you obtain 2020, this is total number of boys in college. Now we need to find the ratio of number of boys to the number of students. So number of boys is 2020, and total number of students in college is 4320. So if here you can see, we cancel 0 by 0, then we obtain 202 divided by 4432, because here 10 is cancelled, then we obtain 432. Again, if you cancel both numerator and denominator, then we obtain 101 by 216. So this is the required ratio of number of boys to the number of total number of students. This is equal to 101:216. Now, so in this way we complete this question and number 10, and now we are going to discuss the question number 11. In this question, this is given, out of 1800 students in a school, 750 opted basketball, 800 opted cricket, and remaining opted tennis. Okay, so first we need to find here how many students opted tennis. For this, we subtract sum of the 750 to 800 from 1800, then we obtain the total student who opted tennis. After this is given that find the ratio of number of students who opted basketball to the number to the number of students who opted table tennis. Okay,
So here number of student 750 is obtained basketball, and after this you need to even find to number of student. After this we divide and simplify this, then we obtain number of student, we obtain table tennis. This is clear. And the second is, this is given, find the ratio of number of student who opted basketball to the number of students who opted basketball, cricket to basketball. So here given cricket, number of student 800 student like cricket, and 750 student like basketball. Then if we find that their simplification 800 750 by 800, then we obtain the required ratio. So student, I hope all of you solve these questions. Now we can meet next video, and enough for today. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind.